So dear students, today we are going to start a new chapter of civic, that is the state government. So as India is a federal country, so political power is shared among the three levels of the government, that are local self-government, state government and the union government. So local self-government is at the bottom and the union government is at the top. So today we are going to discuss about the state government. So first of all, we will discuss about the organs of the government. So there are three organs of the government. First is legislature, that makes the laws. And second is executive, that implements the laws made by the legislature. And third is judiciary. So judiciary checks on the powers and the functions of the legislature and the executive. It means it checks whether they are working according to constitution or not. So it also provides the justice to the people. So these are the three organs of the government. Now the state legislature. So there are two forms of state legislature. One is unicameral and other is bicameral. So state legislature is a law making body for the state. So there are two forms of state legislature, unicameral and the bicameral. So unicameral legislature is having only one house of legislature, that is legislative assembly or Vidhan Sabha. So Haryana is also example of unicameral legislature, as it is having only one house of legislature, that is legislative assembly or Vidhan Sabha. It is known as lower house. Other is bicameral legislature. So bicameral legislature is having two houses of legislature, that are legislative assembly or Vidhan Sabha, and other is legislative council or Vidhan Parishad. So in India there are six states that are having the bicameral legislature. So they are Uttarakhand, UP, Karnataka, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. So these six states are having bicameral legislature. So here we are going to discuss features of the legislative assembly. So first one is, it is law making body for the state. And other is, its strength depends upon the population of the state. If the population is large, then the number will be enlarged. And if the population is less, then the number of the legislative assembly will be also less. And the members are elected by the common people. So legislative assembly's members are elected by the common people. And the members differ state to state according to population of the state. So Haryana Legislative Assembly is having 90 members according to its population. Then method of election for the Legislative Assembly members. Then these are directly elected by the Universal Adult Franchise. So what is Universal Adult Franchise? Universal Adult Franchise allows all the citizens to give the one vote without any discrimination. It means the people who are having the age of 18 or above, belonging to particular state, can give the vote for the members of Legislative Assembly without any discrimination of caste, color of the skin, religion, etc. It means there will be no discrimination among the citizen. Everyone who is belonging to that particular state and having the age of 18 or above can give the vote. Then the state is divided into number of constituencies. It means according to population, the state will be divided into number of constituencies, and from each constituency one member will be elected, that will be known as MLA. And the candidates contest election on the name of political party. It means the members who are contesting the election. They are contesting in the name of political party. For example, BJP, Congress, in LO, in Haryana. So they are belonging to one particular political party. Then the member who are belonging to ruling party, it means the political party that is having the majority of votes, means more than 50% of vote, is known as ruling party. And that particular party will be rule on that particular state. So they are known as ruling party. And they become MLAs. Sometimes there are some members of legislative assembly, they are not belonging to the ruling party because they have won from their own constituency but not belonging to ruling party. So they will be also the member of legislative assembly and will be known as MLAs and will belong to opposition party. It means the party who are not winning, they all are known as opposition rather than the ruling party. And then for majority, more than 50% of votes are required. And all other members belong to the other political party rather than ruling party, they are known as opposition.